Shanice, I love your smile here on BBC Radio Shropshire. Now, what do you know about sickle cell? Because it's a life-threatening blood disorder, particularly common in people with an African or Caribbean family background. Now, people with the disease say they're facing racial and socio-economical bias during the treatment. Now, the charity Plasma of Hope say patients complain their quality of life is poor because of pain and fatigue, while 7 in 10 miss work or school because of it. But they say health professionals do not fully understand the condition and do not treat them with the care and respect they need. Now, the CEO is Marie-Claire Kofi and has sickle cell herself. Marie joins me now. Hello, Marie. Thank you for coming on the show this afternoon.
Hello, thanks for having me on your show.
It's an absolute pleasure. So can you start by telling us, for those that don't know, in a little bit more detail, what is sickle cell?
Thank you. So sickle cell, in a layman's point of view, is a genetic blood disorder. And what we mean by that is you get it from both parents. That means you're born with it. So just so you know, you cannot catch it from an individual. And what when we say it's a sickle cell disease, it means that the shape of the red blood cell is different. So the general public has a normal round red blood cell, but people with sickle cell do have a sickled red blood shape or a half moon red blood shape. And because of the shape of that red blood cell, it means you don't have enough oxygen flowing through the very tiny blood vessels. And because of that, you do not get enough oxygen going through your system, and you can have organ damage, you know, and all kinds of complications that come with sickle cell, and gets you really tired and painful crisis.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. So, yeah. You know, you just mentioned there a couple of the symptoms. So what are the everyday challenges that people have when living with sickle cell?
So there's a number of challenges that people face, and everyone has a different manifestations and symptoms of sickle cell. But generally, people with sickle cell do have pain every single day. It can be at different levels, different magnitudes. They feel very tired. They go through a lot of mental and psychological challenges, because living with pain every day takes a lot out of you. And also it has so much effect on the family as a whole, you know, because of some of the painful crises that come with sickle cell. People tend to miss school, miss work, and this has a lot of impact on your financial well-being, physical and emotional, and you name it.
Wow, so this isn't something that, you know, you don't only just have to deal with the fact of having the condition, but like you said, some people can't go to work, some people can't just function on a day-to-day life, and they struggle with money and things like that. That must be such a toll on your mental health as well.
It is, especially on your mental health, and that's the reason why we're raising so much awareness. I mean, Sickle Cell Awareness Day is coming on the 19th of June, but we have to bear in mind that people live with this condition every single day. So it's important to be creating awareness every single day. But we are highlighting this on the 19th of June to make every single person in the healthcare, in the community, across the board, to understand some of the challenges that people live with sickle cell go through, and thereby be able to give them the proper support that they need.
So what is the message that you're sort of hearing from your patrons at the moment then?
Well, the message is that, you mean from the sickle cell patients, did you say?
Yeah.
Yes. So, I mean, the general message is that they're not being understood, they're not being heard. When they are in pain, they go into hospital, they don't receive the care that they need. But majority of people, like myself, can say that there is improvement, because from the SHAPE survey and No One's Listening report, we can see that issues have been identified. And the reason we are having these conversations today is because those issues have to be addressed. And, you know, I'm happy to see that the NHS is putting so much in place to address some of these health inequalities.
So what changes, you know, what more changes would you like to see?
Oh, I would like to see for more healthcare professionals to have proper training and understanding of managing sickle cell. And also for patients themselves to become advocates and, you know, accepting the fact that they have this condition and they have to be their own voices, because we are experts by experience. And I can tell you that my life has been much better since I understood what works for me. And until every single sickle cell sufferer accepts that, you know, we are different and it's okay to be different and it's okay to talk about some of the challenges you're facing and how you can be supported, I think we'll all be, you know, having a level-headed conversation. Yes, there are inequalities, but we all have to play a role in this. We have to work in partnership with the health professionals that give us the care that they do, because most of them mean well, and we want to be able to get the proper care.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, just before I let you go, Marie, you know, how can people find out more about Plasma of Hope?
Thank you. People can find out more by getting more information from our website, www.plasmaofhope.org.uk. And if they want to find out any information about sickle cell, you can go to the NHS website or the Sickle Cell Society website. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. That was Marie Claire Kofi there, CEO of the Plasma of Hope, and also has sickle cell herself.
The Wonder Years. 1 hour, 2 years, countless memories. The Wonder Years. Great music and great memories. Weekdays at 1.
BBC Radio Shropshire.